Hello and welcome to HP Calcs. I'm Rick, and today we're going to have a quick look at how to find trig functions on the Casio FX991 MS calculator. To do this, we'll be using the sine, cosine, and tangent keys located along here, sine, cos, tan, as well as the shift key, looks like this, and is located here, and the x to the power of negative 1 or x inverse key, that looks like this. And is located up here. Getting started, these examples will be in degrees, so we want to make sure our calculator is set to degrees. We can confirm this by seeing a little D in the top row there. And if we don't see that, what we can do is change our calculator to degrees mode by pressing the mode key 1, 2, 3, 4 times until we see this screen. DEG, RAD, and GRA. Which stands for degrees, radians, and gradients. Like I said, we want to be in degrees, so we select 1, and now we should have that D on the top screen there. All right, if we're just doing the basics, like say the sine of 30 degrees, we would enter it as we would write it. So we press sine 30 and equals, gives us the result of 0.5. Cosine of 30, again, cos 30 equals 0.8660. And tangent of 30, tan 30 equals 0.577, rounding to 4. Easy enough. But what if we wanted to find functions like cosecant, secant, and cotangent? Well, to do this, what we actually have to do is inverse the result of its corresponding function. So, if we wanted to, say, find the cosecant of 30 degrees, first we have to find the sine of 30, sine 30, press equals, and we're back to our 0.5, and then we want to inverse this with this x to the power of negative 1 or x inverse key, and press equals, and we see we get 2. The cosecant of 30 degrees is equal to 2. Secant, same thing, but done with cos. So if we go cos 30 equals, and then inverse that equals, we get a secant of 1.1547, etc. And with tangent, tan of 30 equals, inverse that to get our cotangent, which is 1.7321, etc. What about arccsine, arccos, and arctan? Well, these are actually represented by the sine minus 1, cos minus 1, and tan minus 1 that are the shift functions on our sine, cos, and tan keys. And we use these to go from the result of, say, a sine 30 degrees, which gave us 0.5, back to the degrees. So if we wanted to, say, find out how many degrees were used to get 0.5, we would use shift sine. So we get sine minus 1, 0.5, and equals. And we see this brings us back to 30 degrees. Same thing with arc cos. If we press shift cos, and then remember we've rounded this to 0.8660, so 0.8660 equals, this brings us back to what would round to 30 degrees. Again with tangent, remember we got 0.5774, so if we shift tan, there's our arctan. 0.5774 equals, this brings us back to our rounded 30 degrees. All right, I hope this helps out there, everybody, and good luck on those tests.